last time on a little El Salvadorian campaign, we declared war on Guatemala, got immediately started to get wrecked, and we had no idea what else to do to try and, I don't know, give us a bit of an advantage against them. Basically, the plan for this episode is to knock out Guatemala if we can, and hopefully we can possibly get the German Reich's assistance, because it's not 1939, and they don't attack Poland until then, so because we have a historical AI. So hopefully, also the Spanish Civil War still going, so I guess. So hopefully we can get Mr. Adolf on our side, and if we can do that, then we'll have a bit of a chance of actually winning. So, let us begin by continuing our higher manpower than us. That's not good. Okay, so I don't have any civilian factors, which is why I'm doing the construction effort. So let's go ahead and continue where we last left off and see where that takes us. So right now, Guatemala is trying to defeat me by doing their classic strategy of rushing right in. Yourself in a situation where you're a military commander and you're leading an attack on the country, don't just slam into an army that's literally indifferent and have a lot of advantages. You're a bad guy who has very high skill and is anything other than a very expert in the field of battle. Now, the best way to do that. Thing I can, well, Now what am I going to be able to do? Well, I can ask... Why would I want to ask for military access at war?
Thank you.
can, however, reduce wage rate, which increases our research speed, our factory construction. The main thing is basically just research speed, because I might need that. And we are now currently 9 days away from getting ourselves the delayed attack, or attacked. So, if we just go here, I'm starting to also see that most of these guys that are the generals can also be found being, you know, different guys you can get from, you know, really powerful towns. Like, you notice, you see this guy, he's actually a general. Nothing has changed. The casualty count for Guatemala has managed to stay the same for the past, I don't know how long, but it's been the same for like, I feel like I should possibly start an attack, but I don't know what will happen. I mean, the plan right now, like I said, it's considered risky. We don't have a plan value. However, when you have a higher attacking command or so, so just for the entertainment, we'll see what happens. Thank you. were defending against the attack. So now they have more than the other guys. I'm gonna go ahead and take this guy. See what happens. That's going to be it for this episode of Hearts of Iron 4, and we're going to go ahead and do a little save game. that. But for now, it seems as though as soon as I only joined the Axis Powers so I could get a bit of a, like, assistance from Adolf and all that. But anyways, guys, this has been a very interesting journey for our second episode of Hearts of Iron 4.